Hey everybody, welcome to part 10 of our Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep Point 2, a Fragmentary Passage on PC, 100% full game playthrough. Slight change of plans, this is going to be the last episode. I don't want to do another like 10 or 15 minute episode, so we're going to go ahead and do our quick review of the story and the objectives. And then we're going to go ahead, fight the final boss, and end this. I mean, the final boss has already been spoiled, but you know, I've got this routine going where usually for the final episode of a Let's Play, I just kind of put the title screen on here, so we're sticking with that for a second. Again, we are still in the realm of darkness. That is where Aqua has been trapped since the end of Birth by Sleep. Let's go ahead and just dive in and get to it. So, there's really not a whole lot to review because, again, this has been a very small game. I mean, our playtime's only 3 hours and 38 minutes. Granted, it would be a little bit longer because I sped up my power leveling, but I mean, this game really... I mean, you're not going to spend no 40 or 50 hours on this game like you would one of the other Kingdom Hearts games. So, I mean, again, very, very short game compared to some of the other ones. Now, what we do have to review is there is a little bit of story here. Okay, so, let's see how much of this there actually is. Okay, I'm not gonna read all that, because, as I've said, I'm still kicking COVID, and I will probably pass out trying to read all that right now. But we know what happened in Birth by Sleep. Terra, Aqua, and Ven set out on their journey, and they all got screwed. Aqua winding up trapped in the realm of darkness. Terra lost his body to Xehanort. And we know that Ven is essentially comatose. So for this game, Birth by Sleep, a Fragmentary Passage, the prologue. The world is coming to an end. As Kingdom Hearts envelops everything in sight, a beautiful spectacle despite the bleak reality. A dark cloaked figure watches from afar, a large black box by his feet. His hands rest upon the hilt of a keyblade decorated with an emblem of a goat. In the center of the blade is a giant, glistening eye that reflects countless keyblades abandoned by their wielders. Okay, so it's safe to say that the opening scene we saw in this game with Lushu watching was not Xehanort's battle, well, was not the battle from Birth by Sleep, but the original Keyblade War. I could be wrong, but I mean, if Lushu was there, I know Lushu wasn't there during the Birth by Sleep fight. Opening. As the battle with Xehanort draws near, Yen Sid reveals the existence of Keyblade wielders Ventus, Terra, and Aqua, three of the seven Guardians of Light. However, all have disappeared from this world. The king had encountered one, Aqua, in the realm of darkness, and he shares their tale. Dark World Castle of Dreams. Wandering through the realm of darkness, Aqua discovers a familiar sight, the Castle of Dreams. There she sees Terra, but he vanishes without a word. Was it merely a vision projected by her hopes, her memories? Dwarf Woodlands. As she continues to explore the darkness, she comes across a glass coffin identical to the one from Dwarf Woodlands. In it lies an illusion of Ventus. Seeing her friend, she's reminded of her promise to return home and wake him. Feeling as though she's being watched, she turns around to discover a mirror. She leans in to touch it, and a hand reaches out and pulls her inside. Once there, she's attacked by phantom versions of herself, all of whom try to break her resolve. Aqua prevails and manages to escape that world. However, it makes her realize the darkness is slowly eating away at her through the weakness of her heart. Enchanted Dominion. Before Aqua stands another familiar sight, this one covered in an ivy enchanted dominion. As she's about to venture inside, illusions of Terra and Ventus appear. Though she knows in her heart her friends aren't really there, she chases after them. Defeating dwellers of darkness along the way, she finally catches up to her friends. However, only Terra responds to her voice, as his heart is still connected to the darkness. Ventus, his expression vacant, still sleeps in his hiding place. Terra explains that Xehanort is looking for Ven. As Aqua is about to reassure him, all of a sudden, Terra begins to act strangely. He's taken over by Xehanort, who yearns to discover where Ven is hiding. However, Terra's heart holds strong and they struggle. Out of nowhere, a large hand grabs Aqua and Ven, lifting them off their feet. As she loses consciousness, she watches Terra muster all his strength and pull away from Xehanort's hold. As Aqua drifts within the darkness, Mickey reaches out for her. She awakens, only to realize the images of Terra and Ventus are nowhere to be seen. She then learns from Mickey that 10 years have passed in the Realm of Light, and that the threat of darkness looms ever closer. On top of that, Terra still hasn't been found. Mickey explains that he's looking for a keyblade that could prevent the spreading of darkness, and Aqua decides to search with him. Before long, they arrive on a beach beneath a clear blue sky, which we're about to see again in this episode. This is the ending. Aqua shares that this is the place she met Sora and Riku, Destiny Islands. Hearing that convinces Mickey they're in the right place. This is the second playthrough, so I'm going to go ahead and read it. It is what it is if anything is spoiled now. They find a cave, and within it, behind a door, the Keyblade. Mickey takes it in his hand. A brilliant light engulfs them, and when they open their eyes, they find themselves before the open door to Kingdom Hearts. To prevent darkness from escaping and destroying other worlds, Mickey knows he must close the door with the combined power of his and Sora's Keyblades. It's not long before Riku appears to close the door, but he's chased by a monster of darkness. Aqua steps in front of the creature's path and is swept outside the cave. The door to the outside world vanishes, separating Mickey and Aqua. As Aqua fights the monster, she realizes that she cannot go home yet, but knows she'll make it there one day. Then together, Sora and Mickey close the door to Kingdom Hearts. Laying on the beach, Aqua watches as the world restores itself around her. Left behind in the darkness, she falls deeper and deeper into the abyss. However, her expression is peaceful and serene. May our hearts be our guiding key. In the dark margin, a figure in black stands amongst the rocks. Slowly, Aqua approaches him. The King's story ends there. Yensid reveals that he had forbidden Mickey from speaking of his meeting with Aqua because no one held the power to rescue her from the Realm of Darkness. However, things have changed, and the King and Riku are determined to save her. Meanwhile, the new Keyblade wielder Kairi begins her training with Lee under the wizard Merlin. Sora returns from his journey to the Sleeping Worlds and reunites with Donald and Goofy. Yensid states that in order to defeat Xehanort, Sora must reclaim the powers he lost from nearly becoming a dark vessel and acquire the ability to awaken sleeping allies. Oy, oy, oy. With that, Sora, Donald, and Goofy embark on a brand new adventure. Okay, so this one, we're about to see again for this playthrough anyway, as we wrap up this Let's Play. Okay, so the objectives. Defeat 30 shadows, nothing special there. We could do that over the course of the game. Defeat 45 flutterings, nothing special there. Carries across the whole game. Defeat 40 flame cores, nothing special, over the course of the game. 30 Neo Shadows, same thing, over the course of the game. 20 Water Cores, same thing, over the course of the game, it'll come naturally. 20 Earth Cores, you'll probably have to farm this one, but as you're level grinding at the end of the game, this should come naturally during that process. Test of strength 1, 60. Test of strength 2, 70. Test of strength 3, 80. If you're playing on critical, you should be getting up to level 99 anyway, so these should come along with that. Defeat 5 Heartless using Counterblast. I don't believe it has to be 5 Heartless at once. You just have to take out 5 Heartless using Counterblast over the course of the game. Master of Fire, defeat 30 Heartless with Fire Magic. That should come naturally. Same with 30 Heartless defeated with Ice, so Blizzaga. Remember, situation commands count, so Fire-ja, Blizzaga, Thunder-ja. Speaking of lightning, use lightning magic to defeat 50 Heartless. That should also come naturally. Frozen Rail Ride. Use ice-based magic to create a rail, then ride a rail the long distance. This was covered in part 1. It was covered in part 2, but it was done in Castletown near the bridge. So if you're iffy on this one, refer back to, I think, the end of part 2. Icebreaker. We did this one in part 2 as well. There was one mirror. Check out part 2 if you need help with this one. There was one mirror where we walked in, and there were a bunch of shadows, and it's exactly as it says, you know. Use Blizzaga, make sure at least 5 enemies were frozen, and then use Thundaga to shatter them. Make sure that you're, like, you know, decently leveled up, otherwise the Thundaga might not do enough damage. But then make sure you're not too leveled up, otherwise the Blizzaga could just outright kill them instead of freeze them. Magic Advantage, to get this one, the easiest and earliest way to do it was to cast Blizzaga against the Flame Cores. Fight and Flight, nice and easy. Defeat 5 Heartless while in midair. Shot Lock does count towards this too. You can do this pretty much anytime. Earn an excellent rating 6 times in a row using Shot Lock. So, this can be done across 2 different Shot Locks. You just have to make sure that you get 6 excellence in a row without a good or a too slow in between them. Use a style change to defeat 50 Heartless. This one came naturally because this just means that you need to defeat 50 Heartless while you are in the Spellweaver command style. Activate Spellweaver's finish command for the first time. That was an easy one. This one was simply for equipping an item in all wardrobe slots, including pattern, and then activating Spellweaver's finish command at any point afterwards. Trendsetter was to equip an item in a wardrobe slot for the first time. Street Lamp Striker is covered in part 1. We got this by hitting 20 street lamps scattered throughout the area. Again, make sure that you keep hitting them until they can no longer be targeted, otherwise they don't count. Top of the Town, this is covered in part 1. It's actually where we went in the second playthrough to get the chest at the top of the rooftop platforming section. But if you're not sure what I'm talking about, go back and check out part 1. That's where we cover this. Starlit Wish. This is also covered in part 1. From the top of the town, like from that very point where that unlocked, all we did was look over by the castle and just chill for a second till the meteor shower started. Heartless the Dwell. This is covered in part 2. Defeat all the Heartless in the room. Now, I believe this one was for, like, clearing all of the mirrors. Mystery Within, this one, again, is covered in part 2. This was specifically for... Let me pull out my cheat sheet here. Okay, so the Heartless that Dwell was for clearing all the rooms. The Mystery Within, this one is tied to the room where you had to strike the four candles that make the enemies appear. Treasure Within, this was also covered in part two. This is the room where the mirror showed all the treasure chests open but one, and you had to open the one that was closed in the mirror. Gem Gatherer, this is covered in part two. This was for gathering the seven like bright white crystals scattered across the mines area. Connected, this one was covered in part two. This we got by perfectly lining up those two moving platforms with a half a star on each one. Queen of the Rink, perform a spin during the fight with Phantom Aqua. All that means is that you have to use the Spellweaver's finish command sometime during the fight. And I believe this only applies to the original boss version, not the powered up one we fought last episode. Defeat the Dark Sides, this was covered in part three. There were three optional Dark Sides that we could take out in between the mini boss and the actual boss. Prickly Problem, this was also covered in part three. Throughout the Forest of Thorns, destroy 50 ivy branches. Remember to use fire on the red ones. Fairy Bouquet, find flowers that represent flora, fauna, and Merryweather. Again, if you watch part three, this objective is covered there. Work together with King Mickey. This one can only be done in the depths of darkness, because that's the only world where we have Mickey with us. Again, this can be a little bit of a pain in the ass because it's completely random when it pops up. But for this objective, all we had to do was just trigger Wayfinder five times. Didn't even matter if we hit an enemy with it or not. We just had to trigger Wayfinder five times. Okay, so from here on were the New Game Plus exclusive objectives. Turn the Tide, we covered this in part 5. Defeat the Demon Tower with Spellweaver's Finish Command. Basically what this was anywhere from Aqua's icicle spin to that final flashbang attack at the end of the finish had to, somewhere in that attack, the Demon Tower had to take its fatal blow. This was covered in part 5 as well. These two were both covered in 5. Get all the treasure chests in the Castle Town and find the Lingering Memory in Castle Town. Again, these can only be completed on New Game Plus. This was covered in part 6. We got the treasure chests and the Lingering Memory in the World Within. Also in the World Within, we were tasked with defeating the Phantom Aqua without taking damage. This only applied to the last one, not the first two. This is covered in part six, but again, I took the easy way out on this one and made use of the trainer because I don't think I could do this again on my best day. So we eventually did In the Mirror and Quest for the Zodiac. So the way they number these is kind of funny, because technically you have to get Quest of the Zodiac first. And this was tied into collecting all the treasure chests in the game and unlocking the Zodiac Mirror, which we did. And then we went into the mirror and defeated all the battles inside, which ended with the much more powerful Phantom Aqua. But, you know, pretty fun fight. I mean, this has been a fun little game. So these are covered technically these are covered in the entire parts 5 through 8 because of the treasure chests, but the actual battle in the Zodiac Mirror we just covered in the last episode, part 9. Treasure Hunt in the Forest of Thorns, and Lingering Memory in the Forest of Thorns. Again, New Game Plus only, these were covered in part 7, along with Sliding Along the Ivy Rails, which that one really isn't too bad. Again, just at that last one, make sure that when you jump into the air you do a regular attack just to stay in the air long enough to dodge the second dark side orb. Again, go back to part 7 of this Let's Play for a better demonstration. Same with this one, Keeper of the Orb, defeat the dark side at the end of the Forest of Thorns without taking damage. Again, on my best day, I could probably never do this one again, so I went ahead and used the trainer on that one too. 48 and 49 are covered in part 8. A very, very, very easy run through the depths of darkness to grab the last 6 treasure chests of the game and the last lingering memory of the game. Combined strength. Yeah, this one definitely, I like it under my skin when it really wasn't that bad. So all we had to do was make sure that we were in Wayfinder Link Attack when the Demon Tower, the second Demon Tower, took its fatal blow. And again, you know, it's not that bad. I mean, same as with the first Demon Tower fight, worst case scenario, if it doesn't work out, you know, don't save over the file, you know, just quit out of the game, reload the save, and try again until you get it. It's not terrible. So that leads us to this one final objective that we have yet to finish. This is, simply put, location Destiny Islands, defeat the Demon Tide on critical mode. This is the last thing we have to do before this game is 100% complete. So let's go ahead and do it. I'm not even gonna bother with these guys. We're already level 99. Let's just make our way down to the beach and get on with this. Now, at level 99, the Demon Tide, even on critical, should not pose much of a threat. I mean, you still have to be careful. You can't just, like, you know, button mash your way through it, but this should be a very manageable fight at max level. Alright, my friends, let's go ahead and wrap this game up. Oh, what's going on there?
This is where I met those children.
So many worlds have been lost, and now they're trapped here in the dark. Wait, you know this place, Aqua?
Yes. I visited once, and I met 2 boys I considered passing the Keyblade on to. But because Terra had already given one of them the power, I didn't.
Aqua, what were the boys' names?
They were Sora and Riku.
I see. We're getting warm.
Huh?
Well, it's Sora and Riku who've been helping me. We're trying to get that door shut for good.
The same boys?
Aqua, if this is where my friends first got the Keyblade, it also must be where we'll find its counterpart. The Keyblade of Darkness has got to be here on the dark side of their world. We'll have to hurry. Come on!
Here we go, Demon Tide, critical. Let's do this. like I said, don't take this thing lightly. Even if you are max level, you still gotta pay attention to what's going on. This, I mean, this is not meant to be an easy fight. Oh, shit.
Let's keep going. I bet it's in here.
Is that what you're after?
Yep, it's just the key I was looking for. A keyblade from the Dark Realm.
A keyblade of darkness.
The Door of Darkness. Tied by two keys. The Door of Darkness. To seal the light. Well, we've got the keys. Now, we find the ones to close the door.
Sorry?
The door between the two realms, it won't let a heart with light pass through. So, only darkness keeps spilling out. We can lock the door by using the two keyblades. But we need help on both sides to get the door shut.
Well then, since you'll be doing the locking, let me be the one to close the door.
Sorry. But the job's taken by somebody else.
Huh? Is that the one?
Yep, the door to Kingdom Hearts. Well, it's not the Kingdom Hearts you know. Not exactly. But even though it's smaller, it's still the heart of many worlds. And even if it's not a complete Kingdom Hearts, we definitely can't leave it open like this. Or darkness will escape and destroy the remaining worlds. It's time. With this key, and Sora's in the Realm of Light, we're gonna close this door. Now, all we need is Riku.
Sora. Riku.
There! That's everybody! Come on, Aqua!
The battle for the Realm of Light is not won. Thanks to Terra and Mickey, I know what's at stake. I'm not afraid. I will face the long darkness. The next time someone wanders into the Realm of Darkness, I'll be here. A light to cut through all the shadows. I will be their wayfinder. And one day, I'll return to Terra and Ven. I am Master Aqua, and that's a promise.
Aqua! Now, Sora, let's close this door for good!
It's beautiful. The stars are out. Terra. Then. Just me again. They did it. The world's being restored. May our hearts be our guiding key. You'll know where I am.
I thought. I heard her voice in the distance.
She sacrificed herself to save me? Why did you keep it from me for so long?
I had to respect her choice.
What about us? You could have given us a choice. We could have gone and helped her.
I know.
Do not be rash, Riku. As Mickey told you clearly in his story, reaching the realm of darkness the first time was not a simple task. And even if we had found a way back in, regrettably, none of us possess the necessary means to get Aqua back out safely. So I forbade Mickey from telling you, let alone going after her.
Why keep it secret?
That much is obvious. If not you, then certainly Sora would have staged a reckless attempt at rescue.
But now we can help Aqua. You and I, we're gonna go find her.
Yeah, count me in.
Yep.
Who's this new Riku and where's the old one?
New me?
Yeah. You're more like Sora.
Should I be flattered? I try too hard to be the role model. It's more fun to just listen to my heart. Which is Sora-esque.
Well, we still like you. Master, I came here because I wanted to help somehow. What can I do?
I have entrusted the wizard Merlin to oversee the training for our new Keyblade wielders, yourself and Lee.
Lee?
He means Axel.
What?
He's a regular person now. He even saved Sora for us. You can trust him. Come on, Riku. It's time for us to go. First, we gotta find an entrance to the Realm of Darkness.
Mickey, take these along with you. The three good fairies ask that you be presented with them. They are new vestments which will shield the both of you from the darkness.
Thank you, Master.
Okay, let's go.
You were gone a long time. What were you doing?
Secret. I'm back! Huh? What? Just us?
The others all had important work to do, so I sent them on their way.
That's great. They could have said goodbye.
It's your fault you missed them.
It is not. I just like to say goodbye to all my friends.
Then do it faster!
I'm here now, right?
We have matters to discuss.
Huh?
In order to defeat Xehanort, there are allies we must gather, acting now to rouse them from their slumber. We have discussed this before, Sora. Your mark of mastery exam was conducted in the hopes you would acquire the power to wake them. However, the darkness nearly took control of you, and your grasp of your new abilities leaves much to be desired. Furthermore, Xehanort nearly made you his vessel, and in the process stripped you of most of the power you had gained by then. I suspect you have already noticed this, correct?
Sora!
Whatever. Happens all the time.
Yes. Chip and Dale are currently analyzing data that Ansem the Wise provided to Riku, and which could offer us a clue to retrieving our friend's lost hearts. I have very high hopes for this data. However, our greatest chance of stopping Xehanort's plan still lies with you, Sora. If you trust the guidance your heart gives, I know we will find all of the Guardians of Light. But first, you must regain all the strength you have lost. Perhaps it is foolish to expect a complete recovery, but it is absolutely vital you perfect one power. The power of waking, which you failed to master during your exam. There's someone who lost his strength and found it again. A true hero to whom you ought to pay a visit. Perhaps he can point you in the right direction.
Got it.
You can count on us to take care of Sora.
I would have it no other way. I put Sora in your hands.
Donald! Goofy!
You can't become a master without us.
Huh?
I never would have thought you'd fail that exam, Sora.
Hey!
Face it, you're just a half pint.
But the three of us together make a whole pint.
Pint and a half.
And don't forget, we'll keep an eye on you.
Oh, this is gonna be lots of fun.
It's not a vacation. Let's go! Count on us! How are we supposed to get there now?
What? I thought you knew.
Looks like all the old highways are closed. Didn't Master Yen Sid say that Sora should trust the guidance his heart gives?
Come on, Sora! Which way? Hey! Would you get serious?
Give me a break. I'm trying. These things take time.
Well, since we've already been before, why don't you try picturing our friends like we're there?
Wow. Sorry, I got nothing. What did you expect?
May your heart be your guiding key.
Huh? What's that?
Master Yen Sid always said that, right before we went off on any of our real important adventures.
Really? Ring a bell?
Maybe I just imagined it.
May my heart be my guiding key. I've got it! Right! Olympus Coliseum, here we come!
So, this time, we've completed the game on critical, we've completed 100% of the objectives, we've opened 100% of the treasure chests, defeated a total of 603 enemies. Obviously, if you leveled up to 99 without using the trainer, it's going to be way higher than that. Style changes performed 22, Thundaga 51 times. With a clear time of just under 4 hours and 30 minutes, which again, if you level up the old-fashioned no-trainer way, will be a little bit longer than that. Alright, let's go ahead and save. So let's go ahead and look at the that last objective and see what the reward for it was. Alright, so... Critical Conquest. Clear the game on critical mode. I don't think I really need to explain much about this one since we literally just did it. Alright, so... That is it. We have completed Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, a Fragmentary Passage. And upon completing this, we have also... Wait for it. We have also completed the 2.8 remix. Because first on this collection we did Dream Drop, which said that it was, which you know, gave us an idea of what to expect in Kingdom Hearts 3. Then we took a trip into the fairy tale age. And then finally we just finished this, which leads us directly into Kingdom Hearts 3, even going as far as to tell us that the first place we'll be going in Kingdom Hearts 3 is Olympus Coliseum. So, the pieces are all in place here. The board's been set, and this very interesting game of chess is about to begin. Kingdom Hearts 3... I gotta be careful what I say here. Kingdom Hearts 3, we will see Xehanort's proclamation from Dream Drop Distance come to pass. We will see the 7 Guardians of Light versus the 13 Seekers of Darkness. What happens in Kingdom Hearts 3 that brings us to that point from where we are now? What happens when that fated clash finally happens? Well, you'll have to wait and see. But this game was an interesting little journey because it showed that there was, you know, a lot more going on in the background of the Kingdom Hearts 1 final mix ending than we saw. You know, it was not only Mickey who put himself in danger to help Sora close that door, but Aqua too, even going as far as to stay in the Realm of Darkness to make sure that the Realm of Light wasn't swallowed into the darkness. And we've now seen the complete journey for Aqua of how she wound up from falling into the Realm of Darkness from Radiant Garden to how she got from there to running into Ansem the Wise and at the Dark Margin. And like it said in the Birth by Sleep ending, all the pieces lie where they may, waiting for the one person who can bring them all back together, and that would be Sora. So, what happens now? Again, you'll see in Kingdom Hearts 3. I don't really want to, like, go on too big of a rant, because I don't want to, like, you know, mess up and spoil something for people who haven't played Kingdom Hearts 3 yet. And, you know, Kingdom Hearts 3 for me is still pretty fresh, and I don't want to, like, you know, have one of those open mouth, insert foot kind of moments. But anyway, so we'll focus on this. So we have seen the remainder of Aqua's journey in the Realm of Darkness. She now waits with Ansem, hopefully to be saved. And... yeah, this is it. There's no more interludes. There's no more delays or derails from our journey. We're coming to the head of all of Xehanort's planning, and we will see that in Kingdom Hearts 3 and the accompanying Remind DLC. I hope everyone enjoyed this game. I hope everyone's enjoyed the entire journey so far, because we have been through quite a bit. This was number 9, right? Yeah, we went through Kingdom Hearts 1 Final Mix, Rechain of Memories, Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, the 358 over 2 days cutscenes, Birth by Sleep Final Mix, the recoded HD cutscenes, and then we went on this collection, we went through Dream Drop Distance, Union Cross back cover, and now we just finished this 1.2 Birth by Sleep Fragmentary Passage. So, yeah, Kingdom Hearts 3, I know it's, you know, Kingdom Hearts 3 is game number 10. Trust me, the Kingdom Hearts community cracks jokes about that all the time, but you know, we've gone through the games in the order that we have for a reason, and again, the only thing I can say without, like, really spoiling anything is when we get to Kingdom Hearts 3 next, a lot of stuff will come together and be resolved. But as is tradition with Kingdom Hearts, of course, there's going to be some new questions that'll have to be answered. But yeah, so Kingdom Hearts 3 is our next game. And like I said, I've got a couple busy weekends coming up, so I might disappear for a couple weeks before we actually get into Kingdom Hearts 3 and start it. But, you know, well, we'll get there. And I need to figure out exactly how I want to structure that Let's Play anyway, because I don't want to be making any boo-boos like I did with this game. So, you know, probably a couple weeks we'll come back and get started with Kingdom Hearts 3. And yeah, that's all I'm going to say about it till we get to Kingdom Hearts 3. As always, I thank you all for watching. Again, I hope everyone's enjoyed our journey so far. As far as this game goes, as far as the overall journey so far, I hope everyone's having a good time. And until we come back to start Kingdom Hearts 3, my friends, may your heart be your guiding key.